your bag, something small. Take what you need and we disappear. Without a trace, we'll be gone, gone. The moon and the stars will follow the calm. And then when we get to the ocean, we're gonna take a boat to the end of the world. All the way to the end of the world. Oh, and when the kids are old enough, we're gonna teach them to
that as the two of you are standing here, you're here because you've realized at a deep level that there truly are no ties on earth so sweet. They're none so tender as those you're about to assume, and there's really no institution on earth as sacred of that of the home that you form. And I know along the way that you two have learned that your home is not, and I'm going to guarantee you it never will be, just the place in which you live, but so much more importantly, hasn't it really become the dwelling place where you've learned to live in the heart and in the mind of each other? And true marriage is the most sacred of all earthly unions. John, are you breathing?
I am.
Okay,
I am.
Okay. Because I'm gonna say it's to be entered into not only reverently, but consciously, with a full understanding of all of its significance. And to be complete, marriage must be spiritual as well as an earthly estate. And when it is spiritual, in all aspects of your life, it does become that harmonious and peaceful, that happy union, which really life itself has ordained. And the state of matrimony is true marriage when it's based upon a deep inner spiritual communion of two souls who each have found completion in each other. So, John, repeat after me. I, John.
Take you, Angie.
To be my wife.
My partner in life.
And my one true love. I will cherish our friendship.
And love you today.
Tomorrow. And forever. I will trust you and honor you.
I will laugh with you and cry with you.
I will love you faithfully.
Through the best and the worst.
Through the difficult and the easy.
What may come.
I will always be there. As I have given you my hand to hold.
I now give you my life to keep.
So, Jonathan, I'm going to have you take Angie's ring and place it on her fingers. Repeat after me. Angie, I give you this ring. And with it my promise.
Of faith.
Love.
And devotion.
I give to you.
My life.
My dreams.
And all of my tomorrows.
And Angie. John, I give you this ring.
And with it my promise.
Of faith.
Love.
And devotion. I give to you. My life.
My dreams.
And all of my tomorrows. I have the privilege of pronouncing you are now husband and wife in love, in interest, and in destiny. And while you two kiss, I think we should all applaud. Please welcome and celebrate with Mr. and Mrs. Jonathan and Angeline Locke.
There's no combination of words I could put on the back of a postcard. No song that I could sing, but I can try for your heart. are dreams, and they are made out of real things, like a shoebox of photographs with sepia tone loving. Love is the answer, at least for most of the questions of my heart, like why are we here and where do we go, and knock on me so hard. It's not always easy, and sometimes life can be deceiving. I'll tell you one thing, it's always better when we're together. It's always better when we're together. Yeah, we'll look at them stars and we're together. Well, it's always better when we're together. Yeah, it's always better when we're together. Just might find their way into my dreams tonight, but I know that they'll be gone when the morning light sings or brings new things. For tomorrow night you see that they'll be gone too. Too many things I have to do, but if all of these dreams might find their way into my day-to-day scene, I'd be under the impression I was somewhere in between, with only two, just me and you. Not so many things we got to do, or places we got to be. We'll sit beneath the mango tree now. Yeah, it's always better when we're together. We're somewhere in between together. Well, it's always better when we're together. Yeah, it's always better when we're together. Together.